Hey, Lewis Turner here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, back with another review, and I'm really excited about this particular one. This is a bit special, what we have here today. This combo amp here, which is the Red Plate RP5OR, and here it is. So some of you may be familiar with the Red Plate name, boutique amps made over in the States, and this one here is new for 2014, new for the RP series. It combines the Black Verb and Blues Machine models and supposedly answers the blackface or tweed argument, which rages heavily amongst boutique amp fans. So this amp should offer the pristine cleans that blackface amps are known for and the edge of breakup tones that tweed channel amps are known for. So we'll go through it and see all the different things that it offers. As you see, we've got a multitude of buttons and knobs and bits and pieces, so there's lots of different variety of sounds we can get out of it. A couple other things I should point out before we continue: it comes with a four button foot switch, which is down here on the floor that I'll go through later. It's got a fully buffered effects loop and a tube spring reverb. There's also a couple of other buttons on the back. There's a switch that flicks it from whether you've got a single coil guitar or a humbucker guitar, and also an option or a voice option for a fat tone. So this at the minute is set on the single coil guitar. Okay, so at the minute we're on the blackface channel, if you like. And so that sound you heard at the start was that. I'm just gonna put everything back to normal, as it were, and then go through the different things. So, working over here, first of all, this input's obviously here, and just above the input, we've got this little tucked away switch here, which is a brightness switch. So in a minute it's at zero. So there's my normal tone. If I switch to number one, play a similar thing. We get a slightly brighter tone, and up to two. So it's even more brighter. So depending on the style you're playing, you can tailor that as you wish. Right, skipping these two for a minute because they come into play for our tweed volume. So we're going to go along to here. So we've got the volume control at the minute that I'm set on for blackface. Standard, treble, middle and bass. There's a really cool feature here though. So at the minute, here's my sound, just standard sound as it is. There's a little trick here with the mid switch. If I pull this out, then this is the sound you heard at the start, which is much deeper and fuller. Much beefier, so a deeper sound there. And also the other thing I did at the start was this is a normal bass control until you switch it here and you think you've come to a stop. If you actually flick it down, we get a stack lift. So again, beefs it right up. And combined with that pull middle sound, we get a really deep, nice, beautiful, clean sound. So much depth to it, and as you can see, our volume is really low at the minute. Right, and then just back to normal. Okay, going along here, we've got a mode control, and as you can see, we've got funk, normal, and fat over there. And this, it says mid boost underneath. So on my pedal board on the floor here, I've got a mid button where I can switch on the mid boost. So mid boosts are great for cutting through whatever you're playing, whether it's a rhythm part or a lead part. Gives you a bit more mid and cuts through the mix of the rest of the, if you're playing in a band situation. So here it is without it. Here's with it. And then we can tailor it here. So a minute on normal, if I flick it this way, we get a funk sound in sort of mid sound. Mm-hmm. right through to normal, and then this end we get a fat sound. So that's cool. So switch my mid control back off, we put it back to normal. Okay, and over to this side. So we skip these a second. We've got regular controls that you see on most amps. A presence control, you can bypass it, so you can switch it off by flicking it all the way down. And then we've got master volume control, which is really important. So these three ones here refer to my drive channel. So again, on the pedal board, I have a drive and a boost. But if you don't want to use that, we can bypass the gain, etc., etc. So here's my drive channel on the blackface sound. Obviously, you've got a separate volume control. And we can increase the amount of gain. Or drive. And this also has a pull shift, much like the mid control, to change our setting slightly. So that's great. And then I could top it up again with my pedal, put it back. I can have drive and I can have boost to it. So I get even more punch. So much bottom end to that sound, it's wicked. All right, so that's, and then everything back to normal again. That's my blackface, very clean, sparkly channel, but with the pedal use, we can get a drive and a boost sound to it. So onto the tweed one. So there's a button on the foot control here that just says tweed. So I now change my sound to that, the idea being that broken up edge, or the edge of broken up tones that are traditional, you know, if you have a small valve amp and you start to crank it a little bit, we start to get those broken up sounds. Switch off so you hear a difference. Back on. And now this is controlled with this volume and tone controls here. Obviously, treble, middle, and bass all have the same effect as they would do on the other setting. And the same here, we can play around with the drive. So a tweed setting with the drive on. Or I can add boost. So yeah, you can see plenty of power there once again, and obviously I could change the amount of gain and drive. You're getting really close to full saturated sounds there that are going to start peaking if I really bring them up in this review. So there we have all the settings. There's so much there to play around with, and so many different possibilities for sounds that you should be able to get exactly the sound you're after. No problem at all. And, you know, as I said before, we've got the fully buffered effects loop. So if you're running a multitude of pedals, you know, your choruses, delays, maybe external reverb, although it's got a fully spring reverb in it. The adjustment for the reverb, by the way, is at the back there. Then you're going to have the perfect setup without disturbing the front of the amp sounds. So this is one of the top-end boutique-type amps, so you're paying that price, and there's a waiting list that you have to get onto. But, you know, you're getting high quality, and the sounds are just brilliant. I hope it comes through as well in the video as it does here in the studio. It's really top end quality sound. And you've got everything in one. So if you're trying to decide between blackface or a tweed, then hopefully this will answer the question. You've got a decent Celestion speaker in there. It's well made, really sturdy, all those kind of things. So on the intro, I played with the blackface sound. So finish off with the tweed sound. I'll put on a mid boost and might introduce the drive as well. And the other great thing about these really high quality valve amps is the dynamic range and the feel you get from them. So I can really change my overall sound just by how much I dig in. Etc. Okay, so there you have the RedPlate RP50R. I've loved playing around with this amp today. I hope all the sounds come across as well on the video as they have done here in the studio. If you're in the market for a real top-end quality bit of kit, then I suggest you go and try out one of these and get on their long waiting list. Hope you've enjoyed the review. I've enjoyed playing this amp today, and I'll see you soon. Thank you for watching.